murder, dragons, wigs, food porn, costume porn, porn, incest, skin disease. House of the Dragon has it all, baby. House of the Dragon arrived under considerable pressure, but the Game of Thrones prequel really brought the heat. The first spin-off from Game of Thrones is a prequel built around House Targaryen. Unfolding 2 centuries before Daenerys Targaryen's attempted invasion of Westeros, House of the Dragon focuses on the lead-up to the Dance of Dragons, the civil war that would consume the continent's ruling dynasty. But don't worry, the show takes its time getting to that. You could say, it's a slow burn. House of the Dragon eschews a lot of the basic structure of Game of Thrones. If Game of Thrones told a story about a sprawling cast, spread over vast geographic distances in a compressed time frame, then House of the Dragon does the opposite. The show's 10-episode first season is tightly focused on its core cast, following them through a variety of life events like weddings, funerals, weddings that are also funerals, you know, the usual. As a result, the first season of House of the Dragon has a structure closer to something like I, Claudius, or The Crown, than it does to Game of Thrones, with each individual episode built around a particular defining event, occasionally separated by years from the episodes either side of it. It's a strange and ambitious format for a major American television show, and it means that many of the show's core cast, including its credited leads, don't show up until halfway through the year. However, it's an approach that works. Although obviously cheaper than something like The Rings of Power, House of the Dragon is undeniably an expensive piece of television. Still, for all its fire-breathing supporting players, the show's greatest special effect is hiring an immensely talented cast of British actors and locking them in rooms with one another so they can exchange awkward banter and occasionally attempt to murder one another. The show's cast is impressive. Emma Darcy and Olivia Cooke are compelling leads as the two women on either side of the brewing battle for the throne, with great groundwork laid by Millie Alcock and Emily Carey as their younger selves. Matt Smith stands out as the hothead bad boy Prince Daemon, part of Matt Smith's rich tradition of playing hothead bad boy princes, while Paddy Considine brings a dignity and poise to the fundamentally decent but largely impotent King Viserys, whose death must inevitably plunge the realm into civil war. You could say it's a full-scale problem. The cast is absolutely stacked, with small but impressive turns from old hands like Graham McTavish, along with new arrivals like Ewan Mitchell. You have to dig pretty deep to find a questionable performance on House of the Dragon, and even then it's mostly a bad accent. By the way, we call that the Watto, because I'm fairly sure it's offensive, I'm just not certain how. If House of the Dragon has a flaw, it's that the narrative is very clearly weighted to one side over the other. The show assumes the audience's sympathy for Darcy as Rhaenyra over Cooke as Alicent. While the show is smart enough to understand that nobody with the skill set necessary to win in this game is a good person, there's a lack of nuance and complexity to Rhaenyra. She's very much a character we're designed to root for in a show that doesn't have too many of them. Still, this is a small complaint. According to showrunner Ryan Condal, the first season of House of the Dragon happened almost by accident, with the production team realizing that they needed to establish these characters in this world before jumping right into cool dragons fighting each other in the sky. This explains the show's unconventional structure, but it's part of the series' appeal. With the first season unfolding over decades for these characters, it feels like a genuinely epic generational struggle. House of the Dragon is a bold and ambitious piece of work, a study of the arc of history and the individual's place within it, an exploration of the various ways that patriarchy asserts itself, and just a cool show about cool people who have cool dragons and do cool dragon stuff. It's worth getting all fired up about. Don't go dragging your feet. The entire first season of House of the Dragon is available to stream on HBO Max now.